Greetings. I'm Sushrut, cataract surgeon at Vijaya Netralaya and Kempegowda Institute of Medical Sciences, Bangalore, India. In this 4-minute video, I'm presenting management of a subluxated cataract. You can see this is a subluxation from 6 to 11 o'clock meridian with surgeon based at 12 o'clock. Hoffman's pockets are made at 9 o'clock meridian. A valve incision is made at 12 o'clock. The anterior lens capsule was stained and a flap was reflected with a bent 26 gauge needle. Then we introduced the bimanual instruments for excess making. Flat form with the groove on its distal tip always engages the flap from below and acts like a platform, and the Rexis hook, which is a shortened Sinsky hook whose distal tip fits into the groove over the flat form. Now the flap is engaged near the shearing margin and pulled for desired shearing. You may have to re-engage several times. The instruments are exchanged between hands once the flap cannot proceed beyond the reach of the platform. The instruments are exchanged and reintroduced. Flat form engaging the flap from below and Rexis hook engaging the flap from above. The flap is caught and the Rexis proceeds. The flap is re-engaged if needed and the CCC is completed. Once the Rexis is complete, we can prepare inserting the Sioni's ring after careful hydrodissection. A 10 O proline suture straight needle is passed through the Hoffman's pocket behind the iris and made to appear in front of the lens back complex by careful indentation of the lens and correct orientation of the needle. Then a 26 gauge straight needle is passed into the AC through the side port, and then a proline needle is carefully railroaded into 26 gauge needle and partially removed from AC. Now we can use a Sinsky hook to fish out the proline suture, and the needle can be removed out of the main valve incision. Now this needle is passed through the Sioni's and ligated to the arm. Now after tying the Sioni's and cutting off the straight needle part of the suture, the Sioni's ring is carefully tucked into the bag. We have to be very gentle during the entire procedure, taking care not to damage delicate tissues. The Sioni's ring is gently tucked into the bag and is gently dialed into the position. Now the Sioni's is gently dialed into the position and the suture is pulled to place the bag in the right position, and a couple of bites are passed through the sclera, so even tying knots can be avoided this way. After this, we can proceed with phacoemulsification. Very gently, we can bury into the nucleus, and the cataractous lens is broken into very small fragments. These small fragments can be aspirated very slowly, making more room for manipulation. And the rest of the procedure remains the same as any cataract surgery. And at the end of surgery, we can implant any lens of choice, including the toric, multifocals, etc. Now, with these two instruments, the bimanual forceps technique is the technique of future, where incision size is being reduced every passing day. Thank you for watching.